Okay. Good day, kids. My name is Winston Wuttunee. I'm Elder Winston Wuttunee from the Pembina Trails School Division. I am a native from Saskatchewan. I was presented this tobacco, which is what you're supposed to do when you ask somebody that, especially an elder, and this was presented to me, and I would come and say a prayer for the school here, and for the teachers, and for everybody that's involved in education in Canada. So I have this tobacco. Now, I told the young lady that presented this to me, whatever you tell me is going to be perfectly right, because what's going to happen when you give it to me, I'm going to say, Father, you have to help me. She had given me this tobacco. She had asked me to help me pray for the school, pray for the division in a good way. Now what happens is when I offer that tobacco like this, the says tobacco knows what we have to do and what we need to do. So you okay with that? All right, tobacco didn't tell you to stand up, but I'm going to tell you to stand up, please. Say that. We need help in Canada to look after education. We give thanks that we have so many people. Say that. We give thanks we have so many people. Now put this in for say, one day, Father, I would like to be doing something like that too. Good, okay, now I'll finish up.
Hello, everyone. I'm Marina Wilson, principal of Dalhousie School, and it is truly a pleasure to welcome everyone here this afternoon on behalf of our students, our staff, and our community. We are so thankful all of you are here this afternoon to share in this special day. So thank you for coming.
So I'm going to ask the students, would you like to have a seat? Because this might be an exciting time, but it could take a while for us to go through all our words. So good afternoon, everyone. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Sarah Guillemard. I am the MLA for Fort Richmond and the Minister of Conservation and Climate. Thank you, Principal Wilson, for the warm welcome to everyone this morning, as well as for Elder Winston, for your opening prayer. We appreciate the words. It's exciting to be here with staff and students today at Dalhousie School. Thank you for inviting me and Minister Goertzen into your school to make a meaningful announcement that will help children and families. We are really happy to be here with you. Before Minister Goertzen makes that announcement, though, I also want to welcome all of those joining us from the Pembina Trails School Division, including our superintendent, Ted Franson, and we've got Julie Fisher over here as well, a trustee. Okay. So, since taking office nearly 4 years ago, our government has worked to improve outdated mental health services. Today's announcement serves as another example of the work that we are doing to help Manitobans of all ages. Here to make that announcement is my colleague and my friend, the Minister of Education, Kelvin Goertzen.
Thank you, Minister Guillemar. Thank you, students, for allowing us to come into your classroom and into your school. It is your school, and we feel very much like honored guests here. So thank you for allowing us to come in and to speak to you and to others through you this afternoon. Your elder, Winston, thank you very much for your song and your encouragement. I loved how earlier, before the program started, and just a wonderful story that is unique to her, but there are stories like it, I think, all through Manitoba. When you hear about people who are coming to Manitoba to make this their home, who maybe were born in other parts of the world, but have chosen to come to Canada, and specifically to Manitoba, and to make this their home, we benefit from it as Manitobans and as a government, but I think we all collectively benefit when people choose to come to our province, bring their shared experiences that they have from other places in the world, and it makes Manitoba stronger overall. So I'm looking forward, Karam, in a few minutes to hearing you speak as well. I know you might be a little bit nervous, but I can tell you that everybody is looking forward to your comments. We recognize that students do well and they succeed in schools for a lot of different reasons. Of course, we are blessed in this province to have wonderful educators, teachers, others who are working in the school system who are the conduit for that knowledge. They transmit the knowledge to young people, and of course, they ultimately are a key reason why our young people succeed and learn in our schools. But there are other things that can impact a student's ability to learn. If they're hungry, if they are challenged with mental health issues or other things that are disturbing in their life. And yet there are resources in the community that can be brought together with the school, and those resources can be applied in the school together with the community to try to alleviate some of those challenges so that young people that are students can learn and can do better and can and reach their full potential if they are dealing with some of those challenges. And so the province has community schools, and we've designated 14 community schools throughout our province that we provide specific money, specific funding for, so that they can be connected in with the community, so that they can ensure that those resources that help students who might be struggling with different things other than their ability to learn, but much might impact their ability to learn, can have those resources. So today we're pleased to be announcing that we're adding 5 schools to the community school roster, including, of course, this school. We wouldn't be here announcing it if we weren't adding this school. We'd still probably be welcome, but not as welcome. And so Dalhousie School will now be a community school. So they'll be able to access additional resources to ensure that they can connect with the community and provide the support that some students might require. That funding commitment will be an additional $1.5 million over the next 3 years, so about $500,000 spread over the new schools, and that'll mean that in total we'll be reaching about 10,000 students a year. So ultimately, we recognize as a province that the ability to learn for students isn't just about good teachers and good education. Of course, it is about those things, but there are other things as well. There are a lot of people who want to come into this announcement, and that's not a bad thing either. But there's a lot of different reasons why young people learn and why they sometimes struggle to do all that they can do when it comes to the education system. So we're pleased to see Dalhousie become a community school along with other ones, and to have more funding, take our positions. You can be the next leaders of Manitoba, because ultimately you will be the next leaders of Manitoba. We want you to be the next leaders of Manitoba, and this investment will help you become that. So thank you for welcoming me and others into your school, and we're going to hear from some other very, very exciting speakers, and then I wish you the very best for the rest of the day and the rest of the week, and of course the rest of the school year. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Kelvin. Just a quick show of hands, who here are wearing their indoor shoes? Yeah, and how many of the adults here are feeling a little bit awkward not having indoor shoes and stepping on school carpets? That was instilled in my habits when I was young and at school myself. So thank you again for inviting us in and not requiring indoor shoes just for this event announcement. So Pembina Trails School Division has more than 14,000 students attending 35 schools. Our next speaker is in charge of overseeing it all. So please welcome to the microphone.
I don't oversee it all.
My goodness, there's a lot of people who oversee it all. We have Julie Fisher here to give some greetings on behalf of the school division.
Thank
Julie.
Hi, everyone. So I'm a school trustee in this area. I'm one of three. So I wanted to just say, on behalf of the Board of Trustees of the Pembina Trails School Division, we'd like to express our gratitude and excitement to the province of Manitoba and to the Dalhousie School community. Dalhousie School has been part of the Fort Richmond community for almost 50 years, and many things have changed. But one constant has been providing a very caring school community. Dalhousie has welcomed a diverse student population for many years, but recently there has been an increase in students from other countries with other experiences. So the school has embraced this change by elevating the need for a more stronger connection between the schools and our students' homes. Having Dalhousie join the Community Schools Program will further strengthen their work in educating our children by supporting all aspects of a child's life and the life of their family. Pembina Trails School Division is committed to educational excellence in a safe and caring community. Having this support from the province of Manitoba will provide our students the tools necessary to develop their intellectual, physical, emotional, and social potential. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Julie. The initiatives that we announced today are meant to help children at this school and all schools throughout the province. And there's no one more invested to ensuring our children have all the supports that they need to grow into productive and kind adults than their moms and dads. Karam Shuker is one of those moms. She's here today so that she can talk about the positive effects that this new investment will have on the community and schools program and on our children and youth.
Hi everybody, I am Karam Shuker. I am one of the parents of two kids at Dalhousie School right now, and then when I graduate from Dalhousie School. I am originally from Iraq, Baghdad. I came to Canada 2010. I lost my family, I mean my mom and my dad. They stay in Baghdad. But when I came to Canada, right away I joined Dalhousie community, which is like, honestly, it was really my family place, which I run all the time when I have any problem, any difficulties with my financial situation, with my son, with everything. Like, I got a lot of support from this Dalhousie School, which is, it's not even just a school. I told you, like, it's a house for us. It's not only for me, like, for, I am sure it's for lots of people, and they feel the same thing towards Dalhousie School. So I had, I'm confused, honestly, because I don't know what to share more, but I'm gonna give you some information about me, why I came to Canada, and what happened before when we had the war in 2003, and we got the Al-Qaeda terrorist group. They came to our country and they did lots of bad things. One of them, which is like kidnapping kids and pay money to return your kids, maybe if they are young or if they are mature, they kill them and that's it. So I had this accident in my family and my son got in this situation. But when he came here, he gave a hard time for the resource at Dalhousie School, and then they pulled him back again to be a successful young man, and he is in University of Winnipeg right now, and he is a successful person, really love to be a teacher. List how can I got all the help from the staff and from the admin at Mrs. Wilson and the office in general, like everybody. I think that's all that can I share.
There's a number of different countries that we can't even fathom the challenges that are faced by families and children and the courage it takes to start over. And I'm thankful that you did find this community. It's definitely one that's embraced many people, and I'm glad that you're here and your son found success here as well. Thank you. So that concludes the formal portion of today's event. In a few minutes, Minister Goertzen and others will participate in a group photo and then be available to chat more with media about today's announcement. But before that happens, I want to welcome back Elder Dr. Winston Wuttunee for a closing prayer and song.
Children. Father, so glad we are in a safe place here. It's nice and warm. There's no guns outside. We're in here and we can just get education. Good education every day. I say this. Thank you very much. Okay, I'll sing now. No, this is almost Remembrance Day, and a lot of our soldiers went all over the world to fight. So I'm going to sing a remembrance song for everybody.
Sarah, can we see you? Yeah.
Can we just get you to this way, right in the middle?
Oh, you want?
Yeah, there we go.
Perfect.
A little more.
Perfect.
Perfect. Oh, you start with Stacy.
Perfect. Yeah. Okay, 1, 2, 3. And take one more on my iPhone.
Always two.
Sarah, can you just move your head a little bit this way so I get you? Yeah, perfect. Thank you.
Just look my way quickly. Big smiles.
One more. Sorry.
And only eight more. Think we got it all? Okay. Thank you.
Well, so they're determined by the department.
Thank you for coming.